Hello everybody, this is Pramita here. Today I'm just going to show you a pocket size junk journal that I have made for a friend of mine. Because I'm about to ship this off, so I want to show you before I ship this pocket size junk journal. So the idea behind the pocket size junk journal started when I saw people using more and more pocket sized traveler's notebooks. They preferred to use this size, which they could carry around. It's very portable. So, and this friend of mine, incidentally, she uses a pocket sized traveler's notebook. So I wanted to make a junk journal in the pocket size. But mostly I have seen junk journals made in the standard size or in a bigger size, or maybe an A5 size. I'm not sure, but I've tried to make it in the pocket size. So this is my front cover. This I've just tied this with a small red satin ribbon, and this is my front cover. It says "Just Because, Share the Love." So this is a paper that I had chosen as a cover. And this is a journaling card that I have stuck onto it. This is a smaller journaling card, and this is an ephemera. This notebook is stitched on this side. So I have made two junk journals, two pocket size junk journals till date. And this one is a stitched one, while the other that I have has been glued together on this spine. All the pages are glued to the spine, so that I have used a tape runner to glue the pages, and it has turned out pretty well, much better than I had expected it to be. Anyways, so as we open the junk journal, I have attached a small library pocket over here, and it has one tag. It is a paper that I received, I think, in the June Planner Society kit. And this is the library card pocket. I've just covered this pocket with some of the washi tapes that are available in Michaels. And that's it. So she can use this in any other way. Next, I come to the next page. Next page, I have stuck, once again, I've stuck in a small cut apart portion that is available over the paper pads that I buy usually. It comes with cut apart sheets. So this was in one of those sheets. So it says hello there. And this is a page from Heidi Swap collection. I don't remember which collection it is, but its size is very convenient for a pocket size notebook, because I think it is a 6x8 pad, so I can just fold it into half and form a page. Like, so this page is the back side of this side, sorry. And this is a journaling card. Once again, I have stuck it as a pocket with two tags inside. One says Love Life and the other says Eat Good Feel. So these tags are all handmade, either from journaling cards or from scrap papers. I have not bought anything for this junk journal. I have tried to use up whatever is in my stash. So this is a page. I think this paper came from a pink paisley. I'm not sure. I don't remember. This is an older collection. I'm not sure. So this is a washi tape that I've stuck, and a die cut. This is from a Kaisercraft collection. Next page, I've just bordered this with washi, watercolor washi from Michaels. And this is a small piece of paper which I've used as a card. And I've just stuck another cut apart sheet, portion of a cut apart sheet. And over here it says, "This stuff matters," so she can journal out here. And a 3D sticker with a small piece of paper. It's just stuck with a washi tape. If she wants, she can take it off. Okay. So the next page is once again a Heidi swap paper. It says precious memories. So she can write about something out here and then journal about it. These papers are extremely good. I think they were made for some kind of memory planner or something. I have used them in this journal. This is a tag that I had in my stash. I think it is from an older Bourbonnie collection. And this is the other part of the tag. It was pretty long, so I've chopped it off from here and I've used it below. And again, I have used a small triangular part of the collection and I've made a small tab sort of thing with the cover paper. This is the back side of the collection paper, and I have just used a small round ephemera. I've used half over here and the other half I've stuck out here. This is a large tag. It says always forever. I've stuck this on this envelope. This envelope came as a form of packaging with the Planner Society kit, I think in June, and I have filled it with some kind of journaling cards that she can use later on. Just that. I've opened up the sides and stitched in the middle so it forms a side pocket sort of thing. This is once again a paper from Heidi Swap collection. I'm not sure which collection is this, I don't remember exactly. And this is a Kaiser Craft die cut. Next is a small ephemera that I had in my stash, and this is a punch out circle. This is a small tab. This page is, I think this paper, I had it in my stash for a pretty long time. I just wanted to use this because I love those roses. These are shabby chic sort of thing. And anywho, this is the back side of that paper. This paper was not double-sided, single-sided. So on this side, I didn't want a white page, you know. So I stuck a journaling card and stuck a few items out here. It says a happy little spot on cloud 9 and calling out. This is a small, what do you call it? You have those title bits on 12 by 12 sheets of paper. This came as a title part in one of the Coco Daisy kits, scrapbooking kits I had ordered earlier. And this is a packaging from Coco Daisy. I have used it as a page out here. Next is this pocket. This is actually a 6x6 paper which I have folded and formed a pocket. This, I think it came from a Becky Higgins Project Life collection. I don't remember the exact collection, I think Inspire. And again, once again, there are small tags inside which can be used as page marks, which can be used in your project life or scrapbooking or even in your planners. So this is this. These pockets are very easy to make. You can simply fold the paper and then stick this part, so it forms a pocket. And I've just cut this in a diagonal fashion so that you can put things inside. And the other half of this is another 6x6 paper which I've used to form a small pocket. So I'll show you that when I come to that. So this is a journaling card. This is, I think, a 4x6 card. So this is 4x6 card on one side, and the other half also has another 4x6 cards. Let me move this aside. So this, and I've joined these two with the help of a washi tape, and I've formed, once again I've formed a pocket. I've just stuck this side and they formed small tuck-ins. You can put in stuff like this. So these tags, I have put in these tags. Some are journaling cards that I've made. Some are tags. So this is the other side of the card. So this is one card, this is another card, and they have been joined together with one piece of washi. This is once again a Heidi Swap paper. I don't remember which collection is this. This is a 6x6 page. Sorry, I think this has stuck. I don't know. Let me. Okay. So this is, I have formed, once again I have formed a pocket. And this is a 6x6 page paper. And this is a 6x6 paper. I've just simply folded the edges and formed pockets. And stuck this side. So these ideas have come from, if you are very familiar with watching to junk journals, you will see that there is a variety of junk journals. They are sometimes in the vintage form, but what I like about this type of junk journaling is that you can use them as a junk journal, as such, memory keeping and storing some things in your pocket notebook or whatever, but this is not a true junk journal as such. This is a quasi or a semi junk journal, but I have been greatly inspired by Doris Sander, who, if you want, you can check her out. She has made quite a number of junk journals of this type, and she has used up some of the papers in her stash, but she has made them in the standard size. So I chose to change it a little bit and use the pocket size as my inspiration, and I have done it in the pocket size, that's why. So this is once again the other side of the envelope where I've put okay, so this has come unglued. Okay, I'll put some glue to it. So this is the other side of the pocket. Next we come to a sheet of this Heidi Swap paper, the other side, because we have already crossed the middle. This is a journaling card I had. I don't remember. I think this is from a Prima collection, older collection. And I have used this as a card. Here another paper from the journaling card from the Prima collection. These are all from Prima. These came from the same collection. This one, they are all from the same collection, and I have used them up. Over here also, it's from the same collection. I've just stuck them with a bit of washi because I wanted to leave enough space for my friend to write or use it in her own fashion. I just didn't want to cover everything up with ephemera or die cuts or pockets or whatever, so that she has enough space to write and journal and whatnot. So once again, towards the end we come to the cover. The cover is, once again, I had taken a larger piece of paper, so I had just folded this paper and attached a washi tape to make it a little bit sturdy. And here is the pocket where I've put some more tags inside. These are all handmade tags from either from scraps of paper or from journaling cards. So this is it. So yeah, that's it. So this is the my pocket size traveler's notebook junk journal. I hope this will give you some ideas of making one. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And please subscribe to my channel for some awesome ideas.